Okay guys, today I will be showing you how to make guacamole.
So in this small bowl, I am going to put two avocados. This is one that I already took out of the shell. I'm gonna show you just how easily, when it's ripe, it's easier to just kind of get a nice scoop, just like that. And I saved this one so I could show you how I cut mine. Move over. Okay. I just cut it like that. Going along. Give it a nice little twist-a-roo. Boop. Pop that seed out. Sometimes it doesn't want to go out. And I don't want it to flick. Okay. Got that out. And then just like I did with the last one, just want to scoop that out with your spoon. Boop. And then the second one. The second half. And that's it. And so we have some onions, some red onions that I already cut up. And we have some nice tomatoes that I diced up as well. No, Bentley. I mean, Bailey. Y'all, I just got a new dog and I keep calling her Bentley. Her name is Bailey. I literally got her like 3 days ago. She's awesome. I will show you guys a picture. I mean, I should put her in the camera, but you know, we're not going to do that. The dog stuff while we're cooking. This is some cilantro. This is optional. Some people put cilantro in their guac. Some people don't. I know some people that do. And you just want to take a few leaves and just break it up. I like to break it up with my hands because this is not something that you want to just spend. It's very tedious to sit there and try to cut it. So I just literally just pull it off the stem. And just to give it a hint of that cilantro taste, you don't want to, the cilantro is a little strong, so you don't want to OD. And then we are going to squeeze. You can do a half lemon or whole. I really like that tangy taste in my guac. So I'm probably going to do a whole lime. I said lemon. Silly me. A lime. I'm going to do both. I'm going to do the whole thing. Oh, maybe I should invest in a lime squeezer or something. Instead of using my hands like a man. Anybody want to cash at me so I can go buy a lemon squeezer? Don't all volunteer at once. And I like to just make sure that I got all of that. Like, I'm gonna squeeze. You gotta put your back into it. You can do it with your back. And then, as you know, I'm always gonna put some pepper, some garlic powder. Yeah, got y'all with that one. And some salt. This is, I'm trying the new, coming over here to the sea salt world. The pink Himalayan salt. Trying to switch it up a little bit. And it's working for me. So yeah, I'm just going to give this a good mix. Then I'll taste it and I'll see if I like it. You might want to add a little bit of something. I mean, it's a little too late to take something, take something out. But you can always add. That's why I don't like to OD with my season. So I like to be able to kind of go back and add what I feel like I need to add. And there you have some good old guacamole. You just want to keep mixing it up until it gets fine. Because I like my guacamole to be like a spread. I still like to enjoy the clumps of the onions and the tomatoes. But for the most part, I like for it to be like a spread. So that if I want to put it on some toast, I can. Or if I want to spread it on a wrap, I can do that as well. And I could also do some chips and dip, you know? All right, so this is what we have here in the bowl.
I didn't have to add anything else once I just kind of gave it a nice mix. This is it. So I'm now going to put it into my little mason jar that I got. I learned that this keeps it fresh longer. Last time I made guacamole, it lasted about a week. As far as being fresh, now it's so good that I'll eat it all before a week is up. But, you know, just generally speaking, before it starts to turn brown, it will last at least a week. You might can get a week and a half in that mason jar with your guacamole. So I'll be back with the finished result once I jar it up. There you have it. Got that all jarred up. And it is good to go in the refrigerator. Or you can have some now at room temperature. I like mine a little chilled. So I'll probably put it in the freezer, let it get a little cold. In about 30 minutes to an hour, I'll sit.